name's Arun Venugopal. I'm a graduate of the class of 2015 at Chelmsford High School. Student of the year, and I'm the student of the same class of 2020. There's an African proverb that says, the child who is not embraced by the village will burn it down to feel its warmth. America's treatment of the black community is seeing another moment of reckoning in our country's history. We are here to remember George Floyd, one black man who, like too many others, lost his life at the hands of law enforcement. But I am not standing here in front of you to specifically discuss George Floyd, or Breonna Taylor, or Ahmaud Arbery, or Philando Castile, or Alton Sterling, or any of the lives that should not have ended so soon. I am here to amplify discussions currently being spoken in black communities, discussions that revolve around action, and tell this community about the long-term actions we must take to improve. One of the best analogies that I ever heard about racism came from Dr. Beverly Daniel Tatum in her book and accompanying interview, Why Are All the Black Kids Sitting Together in the Cafeteria? There is active racism, passive racism, and anti-racism. The cycle of systematic racism, as it has evolved from the slave trade, to Jim Crow, to the war on drugs, to mass incarceration, it can be related to a moving walkway at an airport. The airport walkway moves forward without any effort from us, just as our institutions cyclically and repeatedly dehumanize people of color in our country. Active racism is when you walk forward on the moving walkway. You benefit from the racist institution and you contribute to it by being prejudiced yourself. Passive racism is standing still on that moving walkway. You don't move forward yourself, and indeed you can consider yourself motionless from your point of view. But from the outside we see you move forward. You still benefit from the cycle of racism by standing still. Let me ask you a question. What is the only way you can stop yourself from reaching the end of a moving walkway? You can ask any kid, I'm sure they'll be very excited to show you. You have to walk backwards while the walkway moves forward. This is anti-racism. The only way we can stop the system from continually benefiting certain people while treating others like second-class citizens is to actively fight the system. Only if we work our way backwards on that moving walkway can we reach the place where we started and hit the off switch to shut down the whole thing. So you, the crowd behind me, in front of me, tell me, listen carefully and answer me right here, yes or no. Is there such a thing as passive anti-racism? No! We must be actively anti-racist. We have to fight the issues to bring justice, to stop that moving walkway from moving forward anymore. And that is why, and I'm going to speak bluntly to all of you, that is why if you go home today and you pat yourself on the back for showing up here and you call it a night, then I don't give a damn for any words you have to share on Facebook. Speak louder than words. And I want to believe Chelmsford as a community can take the actions necessary to not just shun racism, but to actively engage it, shut it down, and educate against it. We must show our commitment to black lives through habitual actions. We must set an example to the majority white communities around us. We must work so hard that any black individual viewing our community from the outside sees us walking backwards on that moving walkway, sees us
anti-racist measures and seize our pride. I'm not talking about Chelmsford pride, I'm talking about public school motto that they drill into us. Perseverance, respect, integrity, dedication, empathy. We must dedicate ourselves to respecting and celebrating black lives on a systematic level. We must empathize with our black neighbors, old and new, and create space for them in our hearts and community. And we must persevere to make sure our town's administration is fair to all, regardless of skin tone, that its integrity cannot be questioned. We, meaning you and me, must go above and beyond to show that Chelmsford acts like a leader when it comes to racial issues. We aren't just not racist. We are actively anti-racist.
We will not ignore a person's color, but we acknowledge it, we embrace it, and we learn how their lived experiences are different than our own. Change starts at home. Chelmsford is my home. Chelmsford is our home. I now call upon you, the people of Chelmsford,
to show us, to show the world, the meaning of actions speak louder than words. And I call upon all of you in demanding these four systematic changes in our community. First, change starts with the youth. Chelmsford Public Schools must require all classrooms to include text written by black authors, research and writers, by the start of the 2021 school year. 50% of all English and history curriculum must utilize texts from black authors and historians. We cannot shut their voices out of their picture. Next, the town must hire a diverse, independent group to investigate all of CPS's current curricula, school assembly speaker staff hiring practices, school discipline records, to determine more culturally responsive approaches to all issues regarding race and politics. The town must hire a diverse, majority black, independent group or organization of people to conduct mandatory, yearly, racial bias training with Chelmsford Board of Selectmen, town manager's office, police department, Chelmsford Public Schools administration, faculty, and staff. And we must hold our leaders accountable for failing to successfully complete training. Finally, finally, the town must, in conjunction with an advising committee comprised of people of color, create the position of an independent anti-racism auditor. The first of its kind in Middlesex County, the town must hire a black individual to monitor and report on any and all racially biased statements or actions for police officers, CPS staff, Chelmsford students, and residents at large, and advise our town and school leaders on appropriate responses.
These are not outrageous demands. These are not outrageous, but they require
action to become reality.
They require your
actions to become reality. And I am willing, as I'm sure many here are, to hold a town hall with leaders where we discuss possible methods of implementing these reforms. If you are like me, and you believe that the voices of black people have been drowned out for too long, then you must begin advocating to hear their voices in our schools, our governmental institutions, and in our leaders. Because we're not a black community, and I'm going to be blunt with you again. We're not even diverse. We're 85% white. But maybe, just maybe, if we believe in our power to demand change, starting on a small scale, then we can start changing our reality right here at home. Chelmsford should want to strive to become a place where white and black and Asian and all races of people want to live. A place that stands as a shining example of a 21st century anti-racist town that shuns racism in all forms actively. A place where life, liberty, the pursuit of happiness can be supported for every black life, man, woman, transgender, non-binary, everyone. A place where instead of where we return to where all lives matter, we learn and we express All lives cannot matter until Black lives matter.
The words of the prophet Jeremiah. A voice is heard in Ramah, mourning and great weeping. Rachel weeping for her children and refusing to be comforted because her children are no more. I'd like to invite us in to a time of prayer or meditation, as is your practice. I invite you to translate my words as you need. Dear God, Spirit of life, eternal and transforming love, source of our being who creates us each beloved, imperfect and finite, but also an expression of life, sacred and holy. Incline your ear to us and hear the words of our mouths and the meditations of our hearts as our nation reckons with the heartbreaking and violent consequences of the generations of trauma upon which it has been built. Traumas from the forced removals of peoples from their lands, traumas from the exploitations of bodies for labor and enslavement, traumas of institutionalized and systemic racism and poverty and denial of humanity to whole groups of human beings. We have participated knowingly and unknowingly in a false narrative of the superiority of white bodies over black bodies and brown bodies, Asian bodies and First Nation bodies, immigrant bodies and poor bodies. We cannot yet pray for unity, for hope, or for healing, or even peace. Like Rachel, we must join first in mourning with all the mothers who have lost their children and cannot and refuse to be comforted. Children ripped from their arms to be sold and enslaved, ripped from their arms to be lynched, ripped from their arms to be found dead in the streets, shot in the back, kneed in the throat, by those under the protection of the law. Like Rachel and all these mothers, we must refuse to be comforted. So my prayer today, as we affirm that Black lives do indeed matter, is one of lament, of mourning, of humility, of repentance, turning to see and name the truth and the magnitude of the grief, the trauma, the wrong that has been done and continues to be done. May we gathered here commit ourselves to the inner work of our own souls, as well as the outer work for the soul of this nation, necessary to transform the weeping and mourning truly from prayers of lament into prayers of healing. Amen.
Thank you. Walk up in the bed to clean up froze. They don't fight you when I'm fine. Like the beat, I keep it drunk. You ain't got dough, little boy, you a bum. She give me brain, that bitch go dumb. Be broke, I ain't had no fun. I spin it just for fun. Beat that hair, I'll shake for lunch.
Walk up in the bed with the VVS. Can't get my gun cause I don't do the test. Don't give a damn about how you flex. Pull up with demons all over my neck. Check on blam, don't care who next. See me in camp for you, see three vans. I'm at the show, but I have my check. Chopper gon' blow if you disrespect.
Chopper gon' blow if you disrespect. Got a bad bitch, wanna give me shit. Gang on my neck, go chain with the Chris. She gon' bust it down on the board, and I think. Do a little, care about some crib. Had to drop a road, then I got some bread. Rest gon' eat, ho, gonna get fit. Hatin' on me, little boy, get slow.
Ain't no me, little boy, get slow. I ain't even really gotta call my gang. Got a 30 on me, so I'm by myself. Shorty want enough, I dress myself. Treat it on a man like I gave up. Told me go deep like a wishing well. Hit it one time, you know I built. Diamonds shining on them, can't control
them. Got red bottoms on. Life is good. You know what I mean?
100,000 for the cheapest ring on the cheapest finger, look. Ooh. I done flew one out to Spain to be in my domain, automata. Dropped $3 on the rain, called it Benetrot, look. Ooh. I was in the trap, serving cocaine, they ain't been the same since. Ooh. Granted, she was standing right down while I catch play on the brick. Ooh. I made them look go haywire, Taliban in this. Ooh. I done been down bad in them trenches, had to ride with that stick. Ooh. Who gave you pills, who gave that dust, Pluto sent you on the lick. Ooh. Too many convicts that rolled me to play in this. Ooh, proud of a nonsense, get old, so I'm spreading this. Ooh, they had the candlelight lighting it up. Anybody can get it. Ooh, I'm on a PJ lighting it up. Backwood full of sticky. Ooh, I'm trying to tote that Drake or London and it's extended. Ooh, they got a stretcher. How we gon' die for this? Ooh, yeah, I ride for my d***s. I lied about it. Ooh, we some poor high class, made it, we rich, yeah. I was at the band though, got a penthouse for a closet. Ooh, it's like a shando, lit on my neck, my wrist. Ooh, I got pink toes that talk different languages. Ooh, got promethazine in my blood and Percocet. 100,000 for the cheapest ring on the cheapest finger, look. Ooh, I done flew one out to Spain to be in my domain, automata. Ooh, dropped $3 on the rain, call it Benetrot, look. Ooh, I was in the trap, serving cocaine, they ain't been the same since. That's by the time I call it Serena. I go tremendo for new fettuccine. All fat though, claret the pinky. All fat though, we bought up a Vigil. I'm in the loop with the voo, I'm in the loop with the woo. Who's one your burgers? I put your face in the news. I put the on the shirt. After I murdered it, make me go shoot up the hearse. Cost me a quarter.
Birkin.
100,000 for the cheapest ring on the cheapest finger, look. Ooh, I done flew one out of Spain to be in my domain, automata. Ooh, dropped $3 on the rain, called it Benetrot, look. Ooh, I was in the trap, serving cocaine, they ain't been the same since. Ooh,
100,000 for the cheapest ring on the cheapest finger, look. 100,000 for the cheapest ring on the cheapest finger, look. 100,000 for the cheapest ring on the cheapest finger, look.
I'm not alone, but I'll mourn with you.